हॅलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ सागर रमेश कुटे, वर्किंग इज असिस्टंट प्रोफेसर JMD कॉलेज सिन्नर. टुडे वी डिस्कस मॉड्यूल फर्स्ट. फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज ऑर्डिनरी लाइट ऑफ लेजर. फोटॉन दैट मेक अप ऑर्डिनरी लाइट आर कैरेक्टराइज बाय द देयर एनर्जी, direction of travel and polarization. The difference between ordinary light and laser is: first, ordinary light is polychromatic, means it consists of all constitute color of light. The ordinary light contain wavelength roughly in the range of 400 to 700 nanometers, whereas light from a laser monochromatic means it consists of radiation of only one wavelength. Second, ordinary light is mostly unpolarized, whereas light from laser is polarized, means all radiation are oscillating in the same direction. Hence, laser light is highly directional. Third, the basic difference is that ordinary sources are coherent. That means the disturbed frequency merge to give up intermediate between the maximum and minimum frequency, whereas the laser light is highly coherent, containing the single frequency with minimum amplitude and can be focused to very small spot. Thus, laser light can travel from away. Fourth, intensity of ordinary light decreases with the distance as travel in the form of short pulse of small length and short duration, whereas laser light travel in only one direction, where in parallel to the optic axis. Hence, laser light is highly intense. Laser produces a highly directional, monochromatic, polarized and highly intense beam with a narrow frequency range than that available from common type of source. Therefore, it uses industries, medical, military and photography, etc. This will be the ordinary light and lasers. Now, second will be the brief history of the laser. The light emitted from ordinary light source in coherent beam. The radiation emit from different atom has no definite phase relationship with each other. It is known to all that coherence between source of light and existence of constant pulse relation between them. The two independent sources cannot be coherent. For experimental purpose, two virtual coherent sources are obtained from single parent source. In recent year, some sources are developed which are highly coherent, that is, the light emitted from them has very high degree of coherence and it almost perfectly parallel. These coherent sources are called as laser. Because of high degree of coherence associated with laser beam, it has many important applications in science, engineering, industry, technology, medical, spectroscopy, holography, fiber optics and communication, etc. The word laser is acronym for light amplification by stimulated emission radiation. It is process by which one we get strong, intense, monochromatic, collaminated, unidirectional and highly coherent beam of light. The most significant feature of light emitted by the laser that all microscopic mechanism of emission in effect synchronized by the emission of many atom. So that emit light maintain it definite phase relation for time interval much longer than corresponding to emission of single atom. The principle involved in laser is the phenomena of stimulated emission radiation, which was predicted Einstein in 1917. When an atom is excited state, it makes transition to lower energy state through the emission of electromagnetic radiation. दिस इमिशन कैन ऑकर इन टू डिफरेंट वे. फर्स्ट, द फर्स्ट इज नोन एज स्पॉन्टेनियस इमिशन इन विच एन एटम इज एक्साइटेड स्टेट इमिट रेडिएशन इवन इन एब्सेंस ऑफ एनी इंसिडेंट रेडिएशन. द रेट ऑफ स्पॉन्टेनियस इमिशन इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू द नंबर ऑफ एटम इन एक्साइटेड स्टेट. सेकेंड वन, द सेकेंड इज नोन एज स्टिमुलेटेड इमिशन इन विच एन इंसिडेंट सिंगल appropriate frequency trigger an atom in the excited state to emit radiation. The rate of stimulated emission depend upon the intensity of external field and also on the number of atom in the upper state. When stimulated emission occur below infrared region, the electromagnetic spectrum, the term is known as measure. When the stimulated emission occur in infrared range and above the infrared range, that is visible and ultraviolet range of the spectrum, this term is known as laser. The phenomena of stimulated emission was first used down in 1954 in the development of microwave amplifier is known as MESR. MESR is acronym for microwave amplification by the stimulated emission of radiation. In 1958, Scrow and Tone shows that the Messer principle could be extended into the visible region, and in 1960 Menman built the first laser using ruby as an active medium. Since then the laser action has been obtained in various material including solid, liquid and gaseous, ionizing gaseous, dye or semiconductor, etc. This will be the history of the laser. Now next topic will be interaction of radiation with matter. Interaction of electromagnetic radiation with matter produce absorption and spontaneous emission. Absorption and spontaneous emission are natural process for the generation of laser. Stimulated emission is essential. Stimulated emission has to be induced or stimulated and generated under special condition as started by Einstein in 1970. Absorption of electromagnetic radiation is way in which energy of photon is taken up by the matter. The reduction in intensity of light wave propagation through the medium by the absorption of part of photon in obtain called attenuation. The absorption of wave does not depend on their intensity. The frequency mu and wavelength lambda of the light are related to the velocity of light c by the relation c is equal to mu lambda, that is frequency into wavelength. When a beam of light passes through the absorbing medium, the attenuation of light in medium describe the decreases in intensity of light d into I absorption, which is proportional to intensity of light and thickness of the medium. Di is equal to minus alpha I into dx. This will be the equation number 2, where alpha is coefficient of absorption and negative sign indicate that the intensity decreases with respect to thickness of the medium. That is di upon I is equal to minus alpha into dx. This I will be the this side. Integrating on both sides. Integration 0 to I di upon I is equal to minus alpha integration 0 to x dx. This will be the I is equal to I0 e raised to minus alpha x. Above equation indicate that the light intensity decreases exponentially with the distance in the medium. This will be the interaction of radiation with matter. Now this lecture we will discuss ordinary light of laser, second will be the history of laser, and third will be the interaction of radiation with matter. Thank you so much.